Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's Monday, February 13th, 2017. And we're not going to have nearly as long of an episode as it was yesterday. That was a bit much. We do have a bug that we saw at the end, and I'm not exactly sure what it was. Honestly, I did do a little bit of debugging afterwards. I didn't modify any code or anything like that, but I did try to find out what the source of it was by stepping through, and nothing. It seems like it goes through our code until it hits server travel, and then it just locks up editor and all. So that's out of my code. It's clearly my code causing it, but the part that gets locked up is not something I can peer into. Unless it's the start of the next one and I just happen to not have the correct look in the correct class for it, but it doesn't look like it. It looks like it's caused in engine code, or it's affecting engine code. But the problem is basically that when we launch, it works fine. So all this goes good. We have our piece, and then we have our ability to make our piece and play whatever we want and so forth. Then we close it down and then run the game again, whether in play and editor or in the it's gonna be play and editor, but either in the editor window or in a pop-up window. Either way, it still causes it, AI or not, although AI is always spawned. Major lag? Not on this end. I'm not dropping any frames, and I'm still sitting at the same bit rate. It's possible that Twitch can be dropping it on their end. I guess we'll keep going for a little while. And if we try to click launch, it just locks up entirely. It does make it through the attempt to do a server travel, so it's not in the UI code. And actually, it's a complete lockup. I have to actually go to Task Manager and shut it down, unless I'm running with debugging, in which case I can kill the process from it within Visual Studio. So I'm thinking what the problem might be is that I'm spawning the worker as expected, and having a worker that the engine is not expecting is causing it for some reason to... Actually, I don't even know why I did that. Let's not do that. And having the thread spawn but not cleaning it up or something is causing it to freak out and not want to do certain timers or other events or something. I don't know. We're going to try disabling this. I haven't done this level debugging yet, so I don't know what's going to happen. I think we saw it in last episode that it was required for us to create the thread for it to do that freakout. So let's try doing exactly what we did last time. Go through the game, make a couple moves, and jump back out again. And see what happens. Okay, now let's try to jump back in. Let's see if we can launch. If we can launch the game, like server travel to the menu. We can. So the problem is with creating the thread, or otherwise having a thread being managed. One thing that is possible is that since this is not an actor, it's not associated with the level, or even really a U object. It's just kind of a pretty much a plain Jane C++ class. The problem might be... with the cleanup, we need to actually find a event on game mode. I think I actually have that in my reference. A game mode. Since it always works in a server, this would only affect a server, but of course that that's anyone who's playing a single player or multiplayer game, right? Because if you're single player, your own servers would affect you too. Well, it wouldn't affect them or anyone probably because it's a packaged build, right? It probably wouldn't matter for that. It might affect them if they play like they do a menu level, then they jump into the game, and then they do another game. Either going back to the menu and back forward again. So Mira's getting a bunch of lag, and I'm sorry about that. Like I said, it's still nothing on mine, it seems, at least. Oof, Windows Media Player is really using a lot of performance. Oh, is it actually... Windows Media Player is doing an update of itself. Thanks for doing that, Windows Media Player, in the most useful of time. Okay, so when you're saying lag, are you saying like falling behind, like if I clap, you'd hear it? Or do you mean like there's like stutters and other buffering issues and stuff like that? Or is it just, you know, far back? Twitch has been doing that to me too sometimes. Like as a viewer. So A game mode. Oh, I should actually probably do base, game mode base. Because most of that stuff's gonna be in here. Start to leave map. Oh, okay, so he's hearing the chat of himself. Okay. Because I have my thing set to Bing on, as you hear there, on chat. Trying to think of what I can do on game mode. Where I can clean up on the way out. Game shut down. Stack has been deleted. Okay, so I guess it would be an actor, so I can just do it destroyed. Okay. So virtual void. Oh, wait. Here. Virtual void destroyed. Override. Oops. Parameters. I was gonna say no parentheses. No parameters. So process client ID is above that. Virtual void virtual A base game mode. Destroyed. Then if AI thread. F base AI runnable, shut down. Actually, I don't even have to do that. Void. The wrong button there. Well, not that button. It's several wrong buttons there. yeah, so let's see if this solves our issue. The reason why I didn't care is because shutdown is, come on. Shutdown does if singleton ensure completion, delete singleton, and then singleton goes null. Which is what we need to do, but then I don't have that interesting situation of if I accidentally delete the pointer for whatever reason, on the game mode class, or it's in the process of getting cleaned up and destroyed, called, but it still exists, right? It's better just to call the static member and have that do the pointer check, right? Because it's always going to be there, it's static, but the static will decide whether the instance is there. Anyway. As a matter of fact, I could just had everything be static on that, instead of storing a reference to it. Didn't I do that? Oh, I did. So I didn't even have to store a reference, I could just do begin. Anyway. Anyway. So let's see if that was a problem. Welcome to chat room, Humanitarian One. Someone auto-hosted me. Linux Gaming Cast, thank you. Thanks again. Can I get into the game now? Oh, she's locked up. It's not like it's crunching, it's at 0%, but... Turn true. Wait a minute. Turn true. Instead of doing return zero, let's try doing return true. Because I was having some hard times managing the thread. I'm wondering if just a problem is that return zero doesn't actually work.
Provoking a reaction. Are you slow or are you fast? Man, are you smoking or are you passing? You wishing, are you hoping, are you hoping for
Maybe the problem is Kong is working on exit. And never actually is exiting because it goes through one and it's stuck in here. Your completion. Check on that. So, F runnable. Oh, that's not F runnable, that's F runnable. There. Upon completion, exit is allowed to call. Okay, so we're never actually stopping this. We kept getting stuck in run. So what does Rama have for that? And not is finished. Insert finished. Return is finished. Is oh, it's in there. Yeah, it's in here. It's in their header file. Oh, okay. So maybe the problem is that we had an infinite loop on our run thread that we weren't ever detecting because it was just looping through sleep. So the platform process is like, oh yeah, the CPU's fine. It's just sleeping. I don't know why it wasn't showing when I was inspecting the break, trying to put a breakpoint inside it though, but. That was our problem. Our thread was never quitting. Okay. That may have explained quite a few of our problems yesterday, too. Let's try this again. Let's do one versus AI as well. And make sure it's still allowed. Actually, we'll know that if we to inspect their code. Let's just see if the AI actually works. There we are. Okay, so AI works. There we are. Good. Okay. So, yeah. Let's save this. cd:\unreal_projects, check it, 4.14, dir, git status. I don't want to have that, but anyway. Might be good to see my commit messages in case I'm confused in the future. Even though I hopefully won't make the mistake again. Okay, so there we are. That was actually what I wanted to do today. I'm not planning on making it that short of an episode though. That was only about 25 minutes. I was expecting this would be a nasty, nasty, night, but like if it was about an hour 15, hour and a half, I'd probably call it now, but not for 20 minutes of actual work and 5 minutes of watching chess pieces fly through in a white void with Monster Cat. Anyway, okay, so I guess now what I'm going to do is start cleaning up, so now we know it works. Let's get rid of our comments. Add pretty things to level. Oh, no, I have the moat. Okay, well, if you want the moat, then maybe I can consider it, but I definitely have a lot of things I need to do in this, so... It's not like I have a minimum number of, it's not like I'm, struggling to find something to do today. I have plenty of things I can do today. A lot of it is stuff that I don't necessarily want to do right now. I don't need to do generate, I don't think. Well, clearly I don't, but, this is not a U class. I'm not sure why Yuinub doesn't care about generate. Yeah, so we make the level look more insane. Right now, I'm actually not really too concerned about putting stuff in, because I am, unlike the first time we did this with 4.9, I am more open to the concept of changing things, so I don't really want to make too many big changes, like the, spend 3 or 4 weeks making, the bridge that we did, like, last time. Last time it was supposed to be kind of like a single-player demo. One versus AI and just go with it, right? So I was, if it wasn't too fun, oh well, I'll just gonna cram everything I can in there and have people see the concept and kind of get their mind going. Now I'm gonna try to make it a bit better for usage. So I'm probably gonna have it be a very, very, rough block out of stuff, but I can add stuff like a moat in and stuff like that. That's not a big deal. That's like, that's like box, 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 subtract, 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 subtract. Good, right? But yeah, other than that, yeah, you get the idea. I'm not gonna do something like big in Blender and have it all kind of go in, stuff like that. Eventually it will, but that would be after a bit of play testing. Yeah. So there's that. Let's try building one more time now that I removed all that stuff. Oh, right. Let's try building again. Into an actual build, not a hot reload. So apparently I don't need generated to process the UENUM macro, so I'm guessing it's not a header tool, it's a build tool. Maybe not, I don't know. Or is it the other way around? It's a build tool that needs generated. Anyway. Let's just kick some Alice butt. Ooh, I might get checkmate. That's a very quick checkmate, apparently. That sounds like something I really should protect against. Very easy way to beat the level. Now the easy way to do it, of course, I have to pawn there to threaten, but, it didn't make that choice, so I pulled the bishop. But I'm not too concerned about bulking up my AI like that just yet. Okay, so I guess, you know what, I was planning on doing drop-in code, so people joining the game, I'll try to make it so they can see the process, or if people desync, they can get the game state and reorder themselves. That's a bit of an annoying chunk of code, though, so instead I'm going to... Do what Mir said, and I'm gonna make CrossStreams look better. Wait a minute. Oh, okay. Actually, I gotta check about the queen, because the queen's acting funny. Spawn number three. Spawn number three. So the queen's acting funny, yet the two, the four knights are not. So what's wrong with her? Let's go up in the piece here. So piece. There's only two piece queens, so there's piece bishop, bishop, King, 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 knight, 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 queen, queen, rook, rook. And actually, now that I remember, we did have some problems placing her, didn't we? She was bouncing around. So maybe not placing her directly on a tile caused some issues. So let's try adding her again. Okay, now give her spawn number 3. Save current. Cool, now let's go back to not exiting yet, or let's go back to the main level and let's try CrossStreams. What was it again? Free-for-all? AI Alice, AI Alice, AI Alice. Let's try to see if we can make any situation where the queen be, not misbehaved, where the queen doesn't go the correct color or something like that. Okay, let's try another situation. Let's try where we have CrossStreams, free-for-all. Let's do humans, actually. Human, 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 but have team 3 and team 1. So the first spawn will be blue, the second spawn will be silver, and the third spawn will be gold. So that's all blue. Silver, blue. Silver, silver, silver. Gold, 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 gold. Gold, gold. That's as intended. Okay. As a matter of fact, I'm not gonna have them be team 1, team 2, team 3 in the future. I'm probably gonna switch it over to be team blue, team red, team gold, team silver, and so forth. Oh, someone's trying to message me. Oh, Unreal Engine's auto-hosting me. Thanks for the auto-host, Epic Games. So let's go back to CrossStreams and let's do 1 versus AI. Alice. And let's see, if our queen will despawn with the king as she should. It could have just been a queen with metadata screwed up that for some reason just, you know, didn't cooperate. No, she's still broken. Why are you broken? Yeah, Unreal Engine is, Unreal Engine actually has auto-hosted me quite a few times. They, did a call-out for people who do, Unreal Engine streams, and, they add their channels to the, auto-host list for basically anyone, so that's, it's really nice. I think it was, Alexander, maybe Chance too, but, who, wanted to do that, so. It's really nice of them, yes. So we know a test case now where it doesn't actually work, so, so we're gonna close the editor down. So free for all, the queen doesn't despawn with the knight and the king and everything else that despawns, but the queen does not. So why is that? I think it's game state that controls that, because I wanted to make sure it was for everyone. Oh, I got a lot of stuff to clean. Yeah, crap to remove? Question mark. Yeah, it's all stuff I need to remove. Okay. Okay, so this is when I was planning on doing that, but okay, so for each of them, I get the team, get global team from spawn number, and level pieces, piece state, spawn number. So what's the problem? So I'm going to set a breakpoint here. Actually, I'll set a breakpoint here because this happened before break happened before the line. And we're going to start the game in that situation. And we're gonna loop through all of them because there's only a handful of pieces, and we'll find out why the queen doesn't trigger that. As a matter of fact, I should even use a range-based 4. But anyway. Oh, I think I already know. Oh. I'm modifying the list as I'm looping through it. It's not that the queen, it's just it happens to be at the end of the list, right? Okay, so the problem is the entire code. Okay, I got this. right. What? Oh, no, there. This is on run begin. Okay. Okay, so 4 F piece state current piece in level pieces. In 3-2 current team equals get global spawn or team from spawn. Current piece dot spawn number. And then TRA. Oh, Oh, that's not even that, it's, 8 piece. Oops, no, there we are. I just want to skip the null pointers in case I have a problem with that. Which I really should have done here too. A piece. Pieces to delete. Okay, right, so then we go in here and we do if piece team is less than zero. Burns 248, not too bad. We're actually doing quite a few doing quite a few bugs to be fixed, so it's actually getting a lot better. So the current team is less than zero. A piece. How am I doing? Current piece. Oh, so I do piece net. Let's do this here. I was going to delete it, but then remove it to the list later, but then I realized if I do that, then there's no guarantee that the delete will, cause a problem. Anyway. And do else. Current piece set team current team, and this changed the material to the color we want. And now once we have that, then for a piece. Pieces to delete, a piece, current piece, in pieces to delete, current piece, destroy, level pieces, dot remove, swap, current piece. So this should solve our problem. So we're, for pieces delete, we are adding our pieces to that, and then we're doing that. So instead of deleting them in the loop as we're looping through them, we're adding them to a second list. Then we're going through that list and deleting it stuff there. We don't have to worry about emptying the list because the list is local, so when we reach here, the real engine's just gonna kill it. That works. So, yeah, let's build and run. I was gonna step through on the debugger and I'm like, wait, I know the problem already. The for loop was not written correctly. Oh, for anyone who's just joining us, I'll show you what the game's actually about. So we're gonna look at the first level, and I should tell you something about it. You may recognize this as a chessboard. But some moves are slightly different. Because I just realized that we have, you know, new viewers. You might notice that something's a bit different about it. So, you can move forward. Only move one, though. You can't move two. That's something. Let's actually move the queen. Let's move the pawn sideways. You may be wondering why I added that extra rule in. Well, because, because some levels won't have. Okay, so I can't eat the knight, because pawns can eat backwards. So if I try to eat the knight, you'll see exactly what happens. My queen gets taken out by the pawn moving. Oh, the rook actually, forgot about that. Also the pawn could have moved backwards and ate them. See if I can show that. There we are. So I can move back and eat the bishop backwards. And the reason for that is that on some levels, like CrossStreams, AI there, sure, let's do AI versus AI. On some levels, we don't have an 8x8 grid, we have a, entire map with design levels. And I'll show you a version of this game with a better, more aesthetically pleasing version of this map, but see here, there's knights over here, and then there's a bridge leading forward into a town, and you have to attack the town. And there is a, another group over there. And over here, there is, a third spawn, and thankfully the queen doesn't spawn anymore, yay. And in the original version, this is what it looked like. It was not quite as, good on the mechanics side, but it was a bit more aesthetically finished. Although I'm planning on changing aesthetic. So this is a chessboard level. I want to do open cross streams. As you can tell, there's no menu even. So this is a bit more what I was originally playing for this level, so you can have the option of, attacking into the town. There's gonna be a weather vane there. AI's cross spawns. And there's gonna be a castle going up this way. And a town over here. So the option was you can either take the king and queen and push across the town, or slowly and surely get some, move the king over here to extend, slowly and surely, slowly move your king over here to get, some knights. So you can move this one again if you want, but you can't move this one because it's still out of range. So you can move the king over one more, and now both are in range, so you can move them. And the amount of moves required to move the king over to get in range and move the knights up is about as much time as it takes the AI to absolutely move. Well, if it was a human player knew what they're doing, the AI was terrible. To absolutely blitz and cover your front door. So now you're running the risk of trying to move your pieces out through this wall. You would actually have to either use a knight to jump the wall. But your king can't move out, your king would still be stuck, so you have to kind of make something happen with the edge of your control with your king, with a knight. Or leave out this way, and kind of take this kind of narrow corridors Which is fine for a king and a queen. They are mostly the queen. It's very good there, but the knights really aren't. The knights can only move, you know, from here to there, to there, to there, to there. You know, actually, I should say here. So from here to there, and okay, I can move that way, but, you know, it's kind of stuck to there, there, you know, and so forth. And there was that kind of one alleyway in the back here. You could, if you wanted to, make the king, the knight jump over the wall multiple times, but, you know. Anyway, you get the idea. So, but it'll take a lot of moves to do so, right? Yeah, so you had the option of, do I want knights or do I want to blitz either run inside here and get the queen and the rook over here, or to put pressure on the opponent as they leave their spawn, or whatever, right? So that was the idea of it, and we are now working on, oh, I should actually commit all this. Because we saved, or solved that bug. I don't know what build data is, but... Sorry, folks. That was... annoyingly loud. Yeah, let's do get at all. And, solved. Not all pieces changing color slash despawn according to team color. Okay, so that's good. So now we're gonna start back in again, and like Mir asked, we're going to add a moat. Pure decoration, but it helps a little bit better visualize what's going on. As a matter of fact, I think I'm actually going to need to have the have this drop down a little bit, because the bridge needs to have some height, so this is from the center, -8, and this is -1 meter. That's really a lot. Oh, it's only -100. Oh, okay. Okay, let's try -1500. To make it actually almost a full meter. Which is about the same height of a piece. So let's try this. Okay. It'd be nice if I could actually see my original map and see how much it actually was. I think I'm gonna start with this chunk first, so let's create a box. Geometry box brush. And then Unreal Engine decides, oh wait, I'm gonna have to change my lighting now. Okay, so each of these periods are 300 meters, so we need 300 centimeters, or 3 meters, so we need 12. So here is, let's open Notepad. Hey, welcome to the chat. Vitergamer Play HD. How's it going? Can someone help me with this error? Sure, what's the error? If I can, of course. So that's, N17. So, minus 750, divided by 2, of course, plus 750. 7200, okay. Come on. Should have known. Okay, now that's... Perspective top. Okay. that's actually pretty good. Start here, and then let's carve. Let's start from over here. We want to be halfway, so we want to be aligned with this. Okay. So that we'll cut like so. Okay. Now let's go back to perspective viewport. Now the height I want to be, I think it's 100. So it'll be a, it'll be a 5 meter deep, trench. Okay. Editing, grab, there we are, grab, no, yeah, Unreal Engine's modeling tools are not exactly the best in the world, and they are completely aware of it. So, what's the question, Better Gamer? Okay, so now you are going to be subtractive. There we are. That one hurt. Sorry about that. Now, I do have this built in Blender, but you know. Oh, how I miss the days we'd get carried away, but you had a lot to say. So, what's the, what happens when your hand is slightly off? For rotation around that is 45. We don't have to care too much about any more details than that. Okay, so negative 700 and 600 tall. So 600 tall and negative 700. So that'll be the right size. Have it be from the top, actually. Perspective. So, if that width is 1200, then what's the one side? So it's 1200 squared. Minus 2x squared, but that's, okay. So you know what, let's just instead of look it up here. Okay, so c squared equals b squared plus a squared. So 1200 squared, which is the larger side of that, equals b squared plus equals a squared plus a squared. B equals a. So 1200 squared equals 2a squared. So 14, 4, and 4 zeros equal, or divided by 2 equals a squared. Eight 48, 52. Yeah, that's right. Okay, so 848, 52. So the x dimensions is 848.53, let's say, actually, because round. And of course, we have it on the wrong axis. There we are. Okay. Let's do this from the top. Take it from the top, folks. Is unnecessarily complicated. I could make it much easier by going into Blender, but then I'd have to deal with all of that. So now I can just go this and go that way. Okay. Don't need to be in there, so. No, I don't want to select the edge, I want to select the vertex. And then, okay then, let's go back to the top. something that's good to do without perspective distortion. So instead of doing it all at once, I'm probably going to have it be like this and then create another box. I actually could do that. And then I'll have it be like this and create another box that starts from here and goes out. Or not. Let's just do this like this. There we are. Come on. No. I don't want to deselect at all. Wow. I lined up perfectly. I was hoping to get it close enough and then kind of, you know, mess with it at the end, but if you get it right in the first try, then it'll take that, right? And there we are. Now we just need to create a new one, flip it along the XY axis. I don't know if we can do that directly. Either way, you know what? Before we do anything, we're going to actually do a build. And we will see how that looks. I did have this originally done in Blender, and I just took one big stack mesh and just kind of dumped it in the level and then added some stuff on top of it, but for some reason I'm doing it in BSP this time. And for anyone watching live, tomorrow is Valentine's Day, so, fair warning. Textures. So one problem with the increased, I actually did quite a bit for the lighting, huh? One of the problems with the increased camera angle is that frame rate seemed to have dipped a little bit at max zoom, because there's a higher max zoom, you can see more objects. So I have to be a little bit more careful. I was getting over 100 originally, but now it's significantly less than that, so let's try that FPS. Yeah, so on a... GTX 1080, I was getting about, so I'm getting about 110 frames per second. Seems to be pretty resolution independent though. So a little over 100 on a 1080. Even at lower resolution. Okay, so that's not too bad then. That just means I'm CPU bound. Give or take. So if I'm CPU bound, then I'll probably have a bit better of a time with lower end GPUs. I am doing quite a bit of stuff as well, so I'm encoding and I have, well, the editor is shut down, but. In case you're wondering, I'm not playing in this mode because I have to go through a menu to play. Or otherwise mess with that game state object to give myself a setup. Because I'm in the map, but there's no AI or player assigned to any spawn, so we're just spawning as a spectator. Yep. Okay. Right before the curse. Even though it's not much, but yeah. Okay, so which seems a little low. I know the bridge is fairly high, but I'll have to play around with that. It also depends on what assets I'm gonna put in the game eventually. So yeah, I guess I have enough time to do another one of these. Duplicate. Oh, you know what? Screw it. Let's just have it be like that. So, this is 750, and then here's a 720. Okay, cool. Box here. 1200. Oops, I have to do it the other way around. And then 74. 7200, sorry. I should be able to just transfer over and it's control W. Okay, that's what it was. Duplicate. There we are. Thank you. There we are. No, I'm just gonna go for the top. See what I did there. Okay, so directly in between, there is the far point. So that should be right around. What you're building? I'll show you in just a second. Okay, so now. Okay. Now this one's gonna be easy. Inside 600. So then just gotta grab up in this mode. Grab you, grab you, grab you, and grab you. And then just extend it all the way out this way. And I'll show you what's gonna be in a second. I just need to switch this to subtractive. And then I'm just gonna add one more also they have tips on engine for Fox first person. I'm not sure what you mean by that. Are you talking about like the Fox engine, which is a kind of a Konami proprietary thing? Originally talking about Kojima. But I'm assuming that's not what you're talking about. And we're gonna add a, let's do it right now. Let's add a box here. For a first-person shooter. You can really choose any of them these days. Even Unity and all those have no problem with that. I'm obviously going to be using Unreal Engine because that's mostly what I use. So, okay, so we need to find the value between. Oh, it'll be 7200, 7200. Okay, duh. What? No, you. There we are. There really isn't a whole lot of difference between a lot of these engines when it comes to like first-person shooter and stuff like that. And the game mode doesn't actually matter a lot anyway. It's mostly what you care about with it. Now, Unreal Engine, there's a lot of people using it. It has C++ for the source for the engine as well as the projects. You can do stuff in Blueprints if you want to, you know, test around or do some stuff that's easier to do in Blueprints, like, for example, level events or whatever. Yeah, for Unreal. One thing that's nice about Unreal is it has a lot of templates, so you can just kind of take their template and modify it for your need. As a matter of fact, Cliff Bleszinski, the guy who made Gears of War, his latest game Lawbreakers. He now has his own studio, Bosky. They actually even have Screw Demo as the name of the content, so they clearly just forked the Screw Demo example project and, you know, added their stuff onto it to make a full game, right? Which is now, you know, being promoted by NVIDIA and all that sort of stuff. So there's a lot of that involved, but yeah, the most important part of picking engines in general is what the engine doesn't exactly matter. It's more of what you want to know and what to learn, right? How would you make a paintball? Okay, in a paintball, let's check one thing first. Can I do this really quickly? Okay, so I'm going to do one thing first, and I'll show you after. Okay, so, 1600. Oh, no, I'll be even more now. Let's do 2600. Even more, wow. Actually, a little bit less than that. Let's do 2900. 50. Oh, right, okay. So 2970. And then set you to subtractive. And now when we're back in perspective, we have a nice little cutout here. As a matter of fact, if we want to, we could even, no, I'll have it be the same size. I was thinking of making it dip down a little bit for aesthetic reasons, but no. It would look kind of like, well, this, right? Which kind of looks cool, but, you know. So we're gonna save. So what am I doing? Right now I'm working on a game that is... This is gonna be an old version you're gonna see pop up right now. So this is like chess, but it's not quite chess. I can only move one out of the start. Then I can move my pawn sideways. And then I can move my queen out. And then kill with the pawn, either forward, back, left, or right, or sorry, on any of the four diagonals. The reason for that is because we have multiple levels. So in this case, this level, which is a, I'm working on a remake of in a new version, as which is what I'm working on right now, is a 64 by 64 grid where it's cross spawns. So I spawn over here, AI spawns over here. It could also be multiplayer too, but this version didn't support it. And the idea is to either take your king and queen, go in, pick up more pieces, or you can also move your king over to get the knights. So if you move the king over, you're going to start increasing your control range. Of course, it's, you know, turn. So I make a move, AI makes a move, so I'm wasting moves by doing this, but now I can move this one knight. But I can't move this one, it's still out of range. So if I move my king over one more, then now I have access to both knights. So we are working on a new version of that right now. How long do I spend on this? I do about 3 days a week, but I started in 2014, late 2014 though. But only 3 days a week or so. So now we have the, let's do CrossStreams. One versus AI. This would be team three, so it'll be gold versus blue. Now you can see it's a bit better. We can even do stuff like player versus player, and I even want to have it be the option of, like, so you can see it's similar makeup to the setup, but like the tile setup, but obviously not nearly as done from an aesthetic standpoint. However, the control scheme is much better. So if I move my king here, then the AI makes its move on the other side of the map over there. which it decided to move the queen one space to the right, which has no purpose whatsoever, but it's dumb AI, so yeah. Yeah. But I even want to allow, for example, let's say, off presets for each map, for what I find to be balanced and fun. But if you're a group of, let's say, three friends and you want to play a fun round, let's say you choose a map with 10 spawns. If you want to assign spawns 1, 2, 3, and 4 to player 1 on team 1, and spawns 6, 7, 8, and 9 to player 2 on team 2, and then assign spawn 5 to player 1, assign spawn 5 to player 3 on team 1, and assign spawn 10 to player 3 on team 2, so you have 2 4-sized armies, and then one extra army controlled by one player on both teams, just griefing both of them. How long does it take to get a perfect AI? There is no such thing as perfect AI. The AI currently right now doesn't even account for pathfinding or anything like that. It doesn't have a path solver or anything like that. So it's making pretty much random moves until it gets into combat, and then it starts adjusting itself for whatever it can cover. So if you can kill a queen, if a queen can kill a pawn, but it can be eaten afterwards, then that's a negative trait, so it's going to avoid those. But if a queen can kill a pawn and get away with it, then it's going to go towards those, right? Now, if you're talking about perfect AI, then there's a whole different aspect of what perfect is. No one has made a perfect chess AI yet. We are now currently, as a society, working on typically deep learning, where you just basically give a general AI lots and lots of games and say, these are wins, these are losses, figure out what the difference between all these are, and then the AI will be like, okay, so this pattern led to a win, this pattern led to a loss, and build this giant database so when it plays, it would make moves based on what, you know, the tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions of other games said were a win or a loss, right? That's called deep learning. We're getting some really interesting as a society, we're getting really interesting effects out of it. Like, if you look up deep learning image generation, you're actually having computers create art based on prior good art and prior bad art. And it would actually generate an image, like it would paint an image from nothing based on some parameters you give it and the knowledge of the million other good and bad paintings in the past, right? So it's interesting that all that stuff is happening, and one that really gets me, and I'm really interested in, and I'm wondering, you know, about that, is they're trying to use deep learning as a post-processing method. So let's say if you want to do anti-aliasing or global illumination lighting or something like that, what we do right now is we calculate the lighting and we calculate anti-aliasing by doing samples within a pixel and then determining how much of each color a pixel takes up. Because a pixel is not perfect if you can only see one object. If there's two objects that make up that square space, you might be better off having some balance between the two of them because they'd both blur together in your eyes, right? If two rays of light shine from the same pixel, but they're different colors because they're different objects, you'll get some mesh between them. That's called anti-aliasing. That's what makes jagged edges look smooth, because the edge is between two objects. What we're trying to do now as a society, apparently, is use deep learning AI to not calculate the anti-alias properly, but to generate an image that looks convincingly anti-aliased to the viewer. So we would see, you know, hundreds of thousands of frames from video games in the past, and it would say, oh, this is what anti-aliasing looks like. So if I modify the image as a post-process in this way, it'll look anti-aliased, or it'll look global illuminated, or whatever. So it's, you know, interesting in that we're not actually doing the proper math anymore in those future, like, 10 years down the road video games. We wouldn't actually be doing the actual math anymore. We would just making something that's convincing to the user and looks good enough and looks convincing, right? So there's all of that stuff. So there's no actual perfect AI, and that won't be perfect either. That'll make mistakes, and that's the point of it, actually. Yeah. So there is no such thing as a perfect AI. There is no such thing as a perfect AI to solve a lot of these puzzles. Maybe tic-tac-toe will have one, which is just one that's going to draw on itself every time, just because it won't make a mistake. But there is no such thing as an AI that knows all the strategies. All it can do is make an AI and then add more and more conditions to it, ignoring deep learning. Just add more and more conditions to it that chooses a more and more detailed answer of the best guess it can. So right now, our major problem is that our AI doesn't account for things like having to move its army to a place yet. It doesn't account for anything like multiple moves down the road. I tried, but it was just too slow. We might revisit it now. We have it on a separate thread and so forth. And so on and so forth, right? Then there could also be stuff like, for example, if we have... you saw I had Alice, Bob, Charlie, and Darlene as four different AI choices. Currently, the difference between them is that lower letters like A, Alice, chooses the best move of the conditions I have accounted for. Bob chooses randomly one of the two best moves, Charlie chooses randomly one of the three best moves, and Darlene chooses randomly one of the four best moves. I'd actually want to have them have a bit more of a different variance in them. Probably not for the demo, but maybe for the full game, where, let's say, Alice may be more aggressive, more, you know, interested in making trades, but not, like, maybe make a couple negative trades if it thinks it will pay off later in the future. Whereas Bob might, let's say, be more turtly and be like, okay, if I'm approached, I'm gonna always retreat or whatever, right? And it really comes back from the Unreal Tournament 99, where they had personalities for each of the bots. Like Locke, L-O-Q-U-E, the bot from UT99, had a above average accuracy. So it would miss shots less than any other bot. As a matter of fact, apparently Locke on Godlike, the Godlike difficulty, was literally 100% aimbot. If it saw you and it had a one-hit kill weapon, it would take your head off every time. That ends up being a couple of fun challenges where you see some pro gamers play against Locke on Godlike 1v1, and it just basically consisted of get the sniper rifle, take Locke's head off, and make sure he never gets a sniper rifle or any other hitscan weapon at any point ever in the game. And if you can manage to get a, you know, first to 10 or first to 25 wins, and hey, you beat Locke on Godlike. And that was kind of cool. And I kind of wanted that sort of thing for the check it. But definitely for a demo, I'm interested more in multiplayer, because I cannot make an AI by myself on stream that will compete against a actual human being convincingly, you know, interestingly enough. And, I mean, I think most people have more fun with a game as multiplayer anyway. I know not a lot of people may play multiplayer, but it'll probably give them a bit better of an idea of what I'm trying to accomplish. So yeah, there's no such thing as a perfect AI. Even if you go into deep learning, it's all about making good guesses based on number of conditions. All you can do is add more and more conditions as you have performance for, which a turn-based strategy you have quite a bit of time for. Apparently not all the time in the world, if our previous issues have shown. Although I'm assuming most of that is because of I'm not just resetting the pieces, I'm also resetting the level. So every move has, like, you know, a bunch of times where I am disabling, like, I'm basically reloading 4,000 tiles in the level over and over and over again. That could probably get pretty high performance needs, right? There should be some optimizations I could do for that, but, right? So hopefully I answered all your questions. I was hoping this to be a bit of a shorter stream, because yesterday we ended up doing a 4-hour stream. This is now about an hour and 45 minutes. We solved a couple bugs. So we solved the queen not despawning and other weird bugs with the team colors, particularly on CrossStreams. And we also solved the bug where the game couldn't restart because the AI thread wasn't closing out. So those are done. I guess I'm gonna call it a night. Thanks for watching. I'll see you probably tomorrow. I usually stream Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, 9 Eastern to about 11 Eastern. Sometimes starts at 9:30, sometimes ends at 11:30 or a bit earlier or whatever. It depends on, you know, it varies by about a half hour each way. Unless I decide to get a lot of work done, which can still vary by an hour both ways. Thanks for watching.